might be thinking to yourself, Alicia, why do you look like a Demogorgon? Why do you look scary? Why do you not look how you usually look? Well, that is because today we are going to be applying the makeup to my face because the makeup is not yet on my face. So, yeah. What is up? It's your girl Alicia back with another video. How are you doing? Because I'm doing great. And today, as y'all see by the title, we are going to be reacting to Harry Styles' second studio album, I think, Harry's House. Now, listen, if y'all haven't already, go check out my As It Was video where I basically discussed Harry Styles' like music or whatever. Not his music entirely, but I did state that I don't really listen to Harry Styles, so this is something new for me. But I really want to venture out and do things that you guys might potentially like. So if you are a fan of Harry Styles or you like Harry Styles, this is for you, babes. This is for you. So stay tuned. If you are new to my channel, first of all, hi, how you doing? But second of all, I do a segment on my channel where I kind of do like this makeup and Monday type beat where I do my makeup and react to an album. Tell me if you like that format. I've done it with Olivia Rodrigo Sour and I've done it with Isaac Dunbar's music. So if you like this style of video, just let me know. And after this, I think I'm gonna upload a video on like a TV show commentary. If y'all are interested in that, tell me anything you want me to do, react to, whatever, in the comments down below. I'm going to be doing this Barbie Ferreira look. It might come out like crap, but you know, it's okay. We try new things on this channel and I'm here for it. So without further ado, let's just get straight into the reaction. Also, I'll be looking here because that's where my mirror is and reacted to the video. Y'all already know what we're about to do, so let's just get straight into the video. First track on the album, Music for a Sushi Restaurant. Let's get into it. Hey, I can tell this is about to be a fun album. Like, it sounds like techno or... Wait a second. That tune sounds a little familiar. That sounds like Ant Farm. Is that just me? Or does it that sound like Ant Farm? That sounds exactly like Ant Farm, y'all. I'm gonna insert a clip. Hey, I'm gonna need some lyrics. Oh yeah, I love how Spotify, I'm sorry if I constantly pause the music in this reaction. I am so sorry. They apparently have like lyrics on Spotify and you can like karaoke to it and stuff. I'm here for that. Thanks Spotify, because now we know what they're saying. It says, green eyes, fried rice, I could cook an egg on you. Late night game time, coffee on the stove, yeah. So what Harry's saying is this person is spicy. Okay, lyricist. I like this vibe. No, this sounds like straight up Ant Farm, bro. Straight up Ant Farm. Definitely tell that this song is heavily influenced by some kind of era of music. I don't know the specific era of music, but this sounds very much like that era of music, and I'm here for it. I love that. If the stars were edible, lyricist. Bro, like scary. Don't worry, guys. Trust the process. You know what? Why has anybody told me that this man makes certified bobs? Like, I've never gotten to Harry Styles' gig. Like, I just haven't until now. And I'm like, I kind of love this. It's fun. What is that, Harry? What is that? This is Last Night Talking. Let's get into it. Things haven't been quite the same. Why? It's a haze on the horizon, babe. Okay. It's only been a couple of days and I Give us vocals, Harry. Give us vocals. Wow, this is very reminiscent. First of all, y'all, if I look like a spooky ghost by the end of this, don't come for me, because this is a little lighter than my skin tone. You know, girlies brown in the summertime, and that's what's happening. I mean, I know I'm black, but still, a little too light. So if I look like a spooky ghost, let's just ignore that and enjoy Harry's album. Thank you. This song makes me want to do this. First of all, this album literally makes me want to disco party. Like, is this the vibe? Because I'm loving it. You know what, guys? We're not going to use this foundation because it makes me look like a spooky ghost. Let's just take this off. Yeah, yeah. Turn. Who can he get? Well, I think I know, like, I think he has a girlfriend. So is this album dedicated to her, Harry? Let us know. I literally, and I don't want to keep bringing up his One Direction days because obviously they're over. But I remember literally being a little girl. I mean, I'm still like a little girl, but still, I remember watching freaking You Don't Know You're Beautiful on like Vivia with like On Demand. And I just remember that, and now they're all like solo artists and they're doing their own thing, and we love to see that, because this sounds very different from, I feel like, the One Direction type beat, you know what I'm saying? If I keep pausing these songs, we will not see the end of this video. I will be back. Enjoy Late Night Talking, because this is good. Amazing, show stopping, everything I wanted and more. What is this? Grape juice? First of all, let me just say this man loves his fruits, because watermelon sugar, wasn't there a song he made called Cherry? I don't know. This man loves his fruit. Grape juice, let's get into it. We're gonna use my trusty handy contour palette. Yep, we don't do things traditional over here. We take it a step further and use contour palettes. I like his vibe a lot, more than I intended to. Oops, sorry guys. I like this. I like the vibe. Guys, you see this technique? That's how you get oval-shaped lips, y'all. Oh my gosh, if y'all want a video on how to be a catfish, I'll do that. I'll do it. I'm not even lying, y'all. Like, I really like the vibe of this, and this is only track 3. Like, I love the vibe. It's given, and I'm here. I'm here for that. Like, I can see somebody, like, just chilling on a beach, watching the sunset go down with their lover, listening to this. I can. Or, no, this album gives me movie soundtrack vibes. That's a lot better. It looks way better. It looks way better in the mirror. And when we're done, we'll be like, okay. Okay, so track 4 on the album is As It Was. We have listened to As It Was, and again, shameless plug, if you haven't seen me react to As It Was, go ahead and watch that after this video. We are going to skip As It Was because, I mean, we already saw it. It was a verified bop, and I love to see it, but we are going to skip for the time being. This is track 5, Daylight. What? wait. I'll look away for 1 second. Let me read the lyrics, y'all, if y'all didn't catch that. Looking for life out there, reading your horoscope. You were just doing cocaine. This is a family friendly channel. We are going to be using my trusty handy heart mirror. Well, I love how his music so far, this album, it's very like, it could be considered indie. Don't, I might not, but like low key indie, low key rock influenced. Is that his vibe? I don't know. Oh, okay. I'm starting to hear the vibe of this song. So he's basically saying like daylight is basically keeping them apart because they both have things to do in the daytime. So they're not spending enough time together. Is that what he's saying? Let's see. They're far apart. I like that. I love this rock influence in his music. Like, whoa. Where's that coming from, bro? I like his vibe a lot. Like, I'm probably gonna keep saying that throughout this album reaction, but I'm really enjoying his vibe. So while that's setting and baking and doing all the good things, we're gonna move on to the album. I like that so far. 5 for 5. I mean, is this track 5? Let's go check. Yep, 5 for 5. Like, I'm loving these songs. I really like it. 6 track is Little Freak. Little Freak Jezebel. Jezebel, Harry, Jezebel. What? Why are we talking about Jezebel from the Bible? First of all, let me just say, I don't know if he is the writer or composer for these songs, but I like the writing style. And I also want to say, if y'all have seen my sour reaction, I feel like my opinion was kind of strong on it a little bit, but over time I actually really enjoyed Sour for the writing, because I've listened to the songs and I've heard the lyrics and I'm like, this girl, she can write. Like, she can write a good song. Like, her writing is so intricate and detailed, and I feel like you would really have to be listening and pay attention to catch that. But I like his writing style as well, because there's so many details in it. And I love when artists can have details or use metaphors. And like, you know, like that Melanie Martinez-esque like metaphor for everything. Love that too. But anyway. Yes, we love a person who can sing and write lyrics. She's athletic girl. That sounds like a girl's combination. So he's like, I don't care who you're with, I like you. Don't bow your boyfriend. That's what he's saying. Karma rules. I like his writing style. Like, what? I think I'm starting to get the hype behind her style. Oh my gosh, I'm in love with this. That was Little Freak. Did he even say Little Freak in the song? Next track on the album is called Matilda. Now, is he talking about the movie Matilda? Let's find out. And I love the guitar. The acoustic is very heavily influenced. Like, unless that's like a ukulele. I don't know the difference. First of all, I'm trying to leave my comments to the end. Like, you know, collective thought. But I have something to say. Like, I really like how his music is not very pop influenced. It's very down to earth, very indie. For a artist that is not indie at all. Like, he's not an indie artist. And by that, I mean, he's not like a smaller artist. He's a bigger artist. I don't know if he's indie, like the genre of indie. I don't know if he is sounding like it. I love the vibe, because these are the type of songs you usually get from indie artists, like smaller artists that, you know what I'm trying to say? Am I making sense? Probably not. This is probably like something that has to do with the movie Matilda. And I'm going to tell you this right now. I don't remember nothing from Matilda. I think I watched it. She's the girl with the little bob, right? I don't know. I like this vibe. It's very mellow.
Matilda, you talk of the pain like it's all alright.
Now we're gonna move on to eyes.
But I know it's none of my business, but it's just been on my mind.
I look like pale, scary guy. See the camera? Definitely, but it's not that bad in real life, I'm gonna tell you. Now let's move on to eyes. Let's go to the Barbie Ferreira picture. It's a smoky eye, it's giving. Let's try it. Ooh. Again, the power we're gonna. Oh, wow, yep. The power we're gonna be using is not important. Okay, yes. Wow, that's right. Okay, we're already starting off to a horrible start. We're already starting off horrible, but yet you guys still decide to keep watching this far. If you're here, hi, thank you, love you. Mwah. Oh. Well, track 6, 7, cinema. This makes me just wanna. I love that. Yes.
Darling, is it cool? But when it comes to this.
This is nothing like the picture.
Guess we're in time. You're getting yourself well done.
We're just gonna change the whole vibe of it at this point. Oh, let me go step back to the lyrics, because I want y'all to know that I really do pay attention to lyrics. Like, I'm not just vibing and having a good time. Like, I peep lyrics. I do. Hey. I see a girl, right? I see a girl walking in, like, a leather jacket past one of those, like, movie-esque, old cinema vibe thingies. You know what I'm talking about. You know. And she's walking, and Harry is, like, in front of her, and he's, like, walking backwards and, like, singing to her. This is, bro, hit me up if you need any music video ideas. Yes. Do I love a scary ghost, guys? Do I look scary? Hey, I'm gonna use my mirror. Can y'all still see me? And then first of all, it's funny because this look, like the darkness of this, gives me cinema vibes. This song, like, I see a dark-esque vibe to it. What is the cinema, Harry? Vocals! Yes. Cinema! Spice! Daydreaming. Yep, we're just gonna drag that along the crease and just give us emo clean. We're gonna clean it up. We're gonna make it our own. Is this whack? We're just gonna go with it. Yes. You see that shimmer? I have an idea. Why don't we just. Yes, okay guys, I have an idea to fix this whole thing and turn it around. I love how, first of all, I love how I'm talking as he is delivering vocals. Let me zip my lips. Let me zip thy lips because he is delivering us Ariana Grande whistle notes. Yeah, and I'm here for it. Yes, I am. Go crazy. Go crazy. Is it giving? What was that? Next song is Keep Driving. Let's jump off the roof. Jump off the roof. You can definitely tell in this album he is very smitten. Smitten Ken for this girl. I'm like, purr. No pun intended. Let's keep driving. That was short. Was that an interlude? Let's go see. It could low-key be an interlude. Wow, this album is almost over. And I'm still not done with the makeup, but on theme, it's on theme. Next track on the album is Seattle. We love the splotchiness. Wait, let me go back to the lyrics. We shared the last line. Is that okay to all the people that, because I know his first album was Fine Line, does that have anything to do with that? Because I have not listened to that album, and now I'm starting to think maybe I should, because first of all, I haven't heard a song I didn't like off of this album, which is saying a lot. Oh, he said I'm in a LA mood, don't want to talk to you. He was being honest. Did I say this song was called Seattle? I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sorry you clicked on this video. This is my former apology. I'm sorry you had to endure this. It's actually called Satellite. But you know some people are illiterate and don't know how to read, apparently. So. Is it giving twin? Or at least sister? Okay, so there is a harsh like line as opposed to this where it's fading out. So we're gonna fix that. I look like I got punched in the face. We're gonna fix it. We're gonna fix it before this is done. Trying to convince myself this is actually cute. Next song on the track is Boyfriends. I love how it went from Ariana Grande with You Ain't My Boyfriend to Duff Cameron. I could be a better boyfriend than him. And now Harry Styles talking about boyfriends. So let's get into it. Sounds like a backwards something. Okay, so then we have to do some decoding because I see some backwards words and we need to get to the bottom of that. Detectives out there, what does that say? what is the beginning of Boyfriends? What, decode that. Somebody in the comments, decode. Boyfriends, they think you're so easy. They think you're so easy. They take you for granted. Oh, he means boyfriends in general, like, oh yeah. Yeah. I look like, it could be a look. It could be a vibe. Don't get me wrong. Very accurate. I've never had a boyfriend, but I've seen too many relationships like this. Am I giving rager? We're going to salvage this with some mascara. Are they just pretending? Some of them. Yeah. Very toxic relationship we're decoding here. Boyfriends. He's literally calling them out, like, you, and not just about how bad boyfriends are sometimes, but how you stay in those relationships, even though you know it's not going anywhere and they string you along. So relatable. Girl, y'all, if y'all want a tea talk or like something, if you want advice, girl, I got you, girl. I got you. If y'all want that. This might be the last track on the album. Let's go and see. Yep, this is the last track on the album and it's called Love of My Life. I just feel like it would only be appropriate to have like a black lip. Like, wouldn't it just be more appropriate? First of all, I'm sorry if this whole video, like the music has been really loud or really, I don't know, unproportionate. I don't know. I like this vibe. It fits my makeup, doesn't it? So I'm gonna show y'all how I do a black lip. Y'all are going to see how I do a black lip. Yes, I use eyeshadow. No, I don't feel bad about it. Let's just get into it. Oh yeah, I feel that all the time. You were or are the love of my life? Huh. Past 10. Okay, now I'm kind of feeling it. Now I feel like I'm giving. I don't know. Oh, your creases and your ends. It's giving book. And that's how I do a black lip. I like this. And I like this deep ending. Like, it's very dark. And I love it. That was a sweet, nice, dark-esque ending. And I loved it. Wow. We have, first of all, let me get the mic. I love how literally perfect timing my makeup all came together as the album was done, which is great. We are 46 minutes into this video. Wow. It's going to be cut short, obviously. So let's talk about the album. If you made it this far, you are a champ and I love you. And you should probably subscribe because if you made it this far, you're probably thinking, wow, like she's a great makeup artist. Yeah. No, I'm joking. That was amazing. That actually elevated me to new heights I didn't know I even could possess. Because as I was listening to the album, it took me through so many good emotions, but at the same time, the vibe was consistent. It was great. It was different, which I like. I like when albums can be different, tracks can be different. I loved that. Oh my gosh. I love that so much. It was great. I love this album. This is the type of album where every track hits. No track was lacking. So whatever goes to the bottom, it wasn't because it was a bad track. It just didn't amount to the other tracks. But I'm gonna just say, like, Mr. Harry Styles wowed me today. I didn't know his vibe until now. I really enjoyed his album. And this is the type of album where there will be songs off this album I will be putting on my playlist. So that's how I know I really like this album. It was very good, very different from what I thought it was going to be. I enjoyed it. Comment down below any of you guys' top three favorite songs off the album. That is all for the Harry's House reaction. I really enjoyed that. I obviously I will be doing more reactions per request if you guys want me to react, sing, talk about anything. As I mentioned before, I will be inserting some pictures of this crazy makeup look, whatever it may be. And I hope you enjoy your day. See you in the next one. Peace.